That's a juvenile bald eagle. And just came down this valley. There's two of them over there. One of them lifted out of the timber, so there must be a dead critter over there. This is a big hardwood timber here in central Illinois. It's full of game, a lot of turkeys. Now there's the juvenile, there's the mother or father flying up the valley there. Bald eagles are numerous now, all the way from Alaska to southern part of the United States. You'll encounter them. You might run into one in Texas. It's a testament for conservation and the different organizations in the United States that mainly hunting groups that are conservation minded. They brought the eagles back along with everything else. But anyway, we're down here in this timber and it's late season. The rut's still slightly in effect, but I haven't seen any evidence of it this morning because it's kind of windy. We're trying to still hunt and kill a deer or squirrel or predator. We'll leave the eagles alone, but hoping for some Thanksgiving dinner will walk up on me today. It was on this field, at the tip of it, a couple years ago, that a monster walked up on me in the end of the season. I didn't even know he existed. Had trail cameras out and hunted this area for years before that and never seen that deer. Kind of a mystery buck, big tall tines. He come walking into a late season food plot. I had standing corn. Dead deer, dead buck. I can't see where they've ate on him anywhere. Rigor mortis has set in. Okay, our favorite part, me and Haji's favorite place to hunt is right across the creek. We gotta figure out how to get over there. But this is the part where either Boss or Haji gets wet.
I think it should be Boss.
This is the part where Haji gets in trouble for getting an expensive camera wet. First of December, it's a great time of the year to hunt red squirrels because they're at their fattest point in their life. Big beefy squirrels, beautiful thick hair on them. That thing's as big as a small red fox. Yeah, I've had a lot of pet squirrels in my lifetime, learned a lot about them. Ate my share of squirrels as well. Can't recall eating any of my pets, but I have had some good squirrel dinners. Grandma used to make gravy too, and that was one of my favorite meals. Biscuits and gravy with some fried squirrel. This next ridge over the top here, usually loaded with squirrels. Turkeys, and maybe a deer will be in there, so. That's number two of the day. Killed a couple the other day. Starting to mount up with plenty of meat for Thanksgiving dinner. Haji and I have been slocking critters all day long. His backpack's full of squirrels. What do you think, Haj?
Yeah, Boss. You know, I think we ought to try like going all over the world, be on call, like superheroes or something, and kill animals that are bothering, you know,
like rabid elephants and stuff?
Oh yeah.
What about man-eaters?
Man-eating lions, that would...
You mean like superheroes?
Like superheroes of the Slocken world, save like a whole village from man-eaters.
Just think of it, Hodge. Just imagine, Hodge. What would that be like?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That would be great.
Yeah.
The Dangerous Adventures of Tim Wells, Stalking a Man-Eater. Tim travels to Namibia to rid a native tribe of a deadly demon. Written by Clint Wells. Illustrated by Steve Karras.
It's gonna be a hot one, Hodge.
Yes, boss. A good day for hunting near the waterholes.
The chief tells me that there's been a lion killing and eating his people. Haji, another young girl has gone missing. We gotta kill that lion.
Look, boss! Vultures! Something's dead.
Oh no, not good. Let's go check it out. We're too late, Haji. Here she is. He's killed again. The beast is heading north towards some thick scrub. Track him, Hodge.
But boss, all we have is a bow and a spear.
You getting soft on me, Haji?
No, boss, it's just that.
Yeah. Start tracking. I'll follow you and watch ahead. If he attacks you, I'll run and get some help.
Yeah. Thanks a lot, boss.
After many long hours of tracking, the relentless African sun begins to take its toll on the hunters.
Better drink up, Hodge. We've been on the track for miles. And by the way he's zigging and zagging, he knows we're on his trail. He's one smart bastard. It'll be dark soon. You build the fire and I'll go for dinner. Keep an eye out for predators.
You worried about me, boss?
Yeah, I'm gonna need you for bait tomorrow.
Tim slips in on a warthog feeding in the brush.
Perfect. Headshot. Go to the light, big boy. I'll take what I can carry and give the rest of your meat to the jackals and vultures. They need food too.
Good work, boss.
Thanks, Haji. Should be some good eating. Put her on the spit.
That's him. He's not happy we're here, boss.
Yep, he knows we're hunters.
He sounds mad.
I reckon so. That looks ready, Hodge. Toss me a piece.
Here you go, boss.
Man, you cook good warthog, Hodge.
Thanks, boss. You made a good headshot, too. Is that where you were aiming?
That's between me and the hog. Let's get some sleep, Hodgie. Don't move a muscle, Haji. That's a black mamba.
As the black mamba strikes at Haji, Tim sends his tomahawk towards its mark with deadly accuracy.
Dang it, boss. That was a close one.
Not for the snake, Hodge. He's taking a dirt nap now. It'll be light soon. We better get moving. We've got a man-eater to kill. Look here, Haji. We had another visitor last night.
What the? He was close. And it was him, boss. Should I start tracking him?
No, Hodge. He's hunting us now. I don't know if it'll be him, me, or you. But one of us is about to die. Haji, you will need to stay calm and trust me on this.
I don't like the sound of this, boss. The last time I did that, I was molested by two horny baboons.
We're gonna lure him in, Hodge.
But boss, we need bait.
Oh, we have bait. He's a man-eater, remember? And you're the bait, Hodge.
Huh?
I'll hide up here, Hodgie. He'll want to eat you at sundown, so try and act scared.
No problem, boss.
Here, take my knife, just in case.
Tim quickly scales the tree.
I got a good feeling about this, Hodge.
I'm not feeling it myself, boss.
Just as Tim predicted, the man-eater took the bait.
Here he comes, boss! Slock him, boss! Slock him! Slock him!
As the huge beast lunges at Hodge's throat, the Slockmaster sends his deadly spear straight through the lion's chest.
I slocked him, Hodge. Holy crap. You're bleeding like a stuck pig, Hodge.
I'm hurting bad. Am I gonna die, boss?
Nah, you'll be all right. Rub some dirt on it. Hodge, we have a man-eater to track.
Here's the spear. Wow, he lost lots of blood, boss. Look, there he is. He's dead, boss. You killed him.
Yep, Hodge. He's dead all right. And you did good work.
How's that, boss?
Acting scared. You even fooled me.
I don't know about this. I don't think this is what I thought it was going to be.